In DaVinci Resolve, when we preview a source clip in the source viewer, by default, we can only set one pair of in and out points, as you can see demonstrated here in the video. And when we do try to set a new pair, it will automatically remove the previous one. But there could be times when multiple parts of a source clip could be very good potential candidates for later use, and you are not ready at this point to bring them into the timeline. So in situations like this, one thing we can do is to right-click the in and out points, and then in the menu select Convert In and Out to Duration Marker. This, as you can see, will convert the in and out points into duration markers of the exact same length. And we can do this for as many pairs of in and out points as we like. There are no limits. And the best part about this is that we can now lock multiple parts of the source clip for future edits. Now, because they are markers, what we can do is to double click each duration marker, and then in the pop-up window, we can give it a descriptive name. We can give it a meaningful name, a name that means something to you as an editor. We can also elaborate on that in the notes section. And we can also very easily change the color of each duration marker to make it stand out from the other markers in the source clip. Now, once you are done with all these, of course, it's not going to mean much if we cannot bring back the in and out points. So all you need to do is to right click the duration marker, and then in the menu select Set In and Out from Duration Marker. This, as you can see, is going to bring back the in and out points for that particular duration marker. And if you're ready to edit that part of the clip into the timeline, you are now good to go. So this method is great for a few reasons. First of all, we can now afford to go through an entire source clip without having to worry about taking an action right away. We can also go to another source clip, and then if we do decide to come back to the other clip later on, you can see that all those markers, they are still there, they're still intact. And if we change media pool to list view, you will see that now this particular source clip can be expanded, and you will see that all those markers are listed underneath it. We can also search for these markers as well by bringing up the search bar up top, and we can change filter by to, let's say, all fields. And if you know the name of the marker, you can simply just type that in. Or what we can do is to change filter by to marker name, and now you will see all the clips with markers listed in the media pool. Another great benefit, as we saw earlier, is that we can easily convert these duration markers into in and out points by simply right-clicking it, and then in the menu selecting Set In and Out from Duration Marker. So now we can simply drag that part of the source clip into the timeline. Let's also just make sure that that is indeed the clip that we have locked in the source clip. And we can also now easily perform 3-point edits as well. So in this case, let's just go ahead and perform a simple overwrite. And once again, let's just make sure that this clip is indeed the part of the source clip that we have logged. Last but not the least, we can also easily delete a duration marker by right-clicking it and then in the menu selecting Remove Selected Markers. We can also select Remove All Markers. This will delete all the markers that are present in the source viewer. And if we look at the timeline, if we look at the clips that were brought in earlier, you will see that all the marker names, description, the colors of the marker, they are all still there. So I hope this tutorial helps, guys. And as always, I will see you next time.